Operation Regenbogen was launched at the end of World War II as a planned mass scuttling of all German submarines to avoid surrender. But U-977 escaped to Argentina and arrived in Mar del Plata on August 17, 1945. There was much speculation about the purpose of the long journey, with many people claiming that the submarine could have carried Hitler and high-ranking officials to the South American country. A full investigation was then launched, which gathered several testimonies from the captain and his crew to get to the bottom of the true story of those 66 crucial days. The U-boat. U-977 was a Type 7C U-boat from the Kriegsmarine fleet. Type 7 submarines were the most common U-boats during World War II, and the most produced in history, with 703. Type 7Cs were powered by two Germaniavert F-46 four-stroke, six-cylinder, supercharged diesel engines while on the surface, whereas two Brown Bavarian C GGUB 728 double-acting electric motors worked on submerged propulsion. In terms of armament, the submarines were equipped with a 3.7cm Flachswilling M42U gun, the marine version of the 3.7cm Flak. It also carried four bows and two rear torpedo tubes. An effective fighting machine, it had a range of 8,500 nautical miles, which limited the time it could perform in the western and southern Atlantic without refueling. The Type 7Cs came into service towards the end of the first happy time, the first wave of U-boat victories against Allied navies near the beginning of the war. When the U-boat campaign was defeated in 1944, these submarines were still the majority in service. U-977 was perhaps the most well-known Type 7C submarine. It was launched in March of 1943 and had a displacement of 871 tons, with a complement of between 44 to 60 men. The U-boat was 67.1 meters long and 6.2 meters wide, with a speed of 17.7 knots at the surface and 7.6 knots when submerged. It was commissioned on May 6, 1943 at the Blohmann-Voss shipyard in Hamburg. The submarine was mostly used for training purposes at the beginning and was not part of any patrols during its first 2 years. It remained in the Baltic Sea until February of 1945, when it received its snorkel and went to combat training in Kristiansand, Norway. On May 2, 1945, at 10 p.m. local time, U-977 departed from Kristiansand on its way to its first war patrol mission. It was commanded by Oberlieutenant Jursee Heinz Schaefer, who issued orders to sink any ships they encountered while crossing the English Channel through the British port of Southampton. However, as U-977 was outbound north of Scotland, it received orders from Admiral Duritz to stand down, cease combat activities, and navigate to deep waters to sink itself. These actions were part of Operation Regenbogen, and all German attack submarines needed to follow them to preserve the honor of the Kriegsmarine. More than 150 German submarines surrendered after May 5th. Given that some had to travel longer distances, the complete handover was not achieved until mid-May. Formal German surrender order was given on May 9th, when Admiral Duritz uttered, quote, "The continuation of the fight is impossible from the bases that we have left. Men of the submarines, without breaking your martial courage, you lay down your arms after a heroic fight without equal." No surrender. Three German submarines decided to escape rather than surrender to Europe or North America. U-1277 sank itself near Portugal in early June, and the crew was interned there. Meanwhile, U-530 crossed the Atlantic and arrived in Mar del Plata, Argentina on July 10th. Upon arrival in the middle of the night, they sent a message to the port authorities saying, quote, "German submarine. The surrender took the Argentines by surprise." Back at U-977, Lieutenant Schaefer discussed the matter with his crew and outlined several options. When he was interrogated later on, the captain said that the main reason they headed to Argentina was because of the propaganda broadcast by Joseph Goebbels, in which he claimed the Allied Morgenthau plan would oppress Germany and enslave its people. They were also afraid of the precarious living conditions in which German prisoners of war lived and how they were forced into labor for reparations. Soviet Premier Joseph Stalin alone had demanded 4 million German workers. The U-977 crew voted to head to Argentina, hoping to get better living conditions, as the country kept agreeable relations with Germany and had a significant local community. 30 men voted for Argentina, 2 for Spain, and 16 wished to return to their families. Those who did not want to continue were allowed to abandon the ship in life rafts and secretly disembarked on the Norwegian island of Holsnøy on May 10th. The rest of the crew then headed for South America. The submarine made a continuous snorkel passage and did not go further than northern Africa during the first 50 days of travel. Meanwhile, the conditions on board were quickly deteriorating. On July 14th, the submarine reached Cape Verde and stopped for a break. Their 66-day journey had become the second longest snorkel patrol, but when later interrogated, the crew did not mention such a long submerged voyage. A report by the U.S. Navy stated that U-977 dove twice, first on sighting a plane and a second time when coming across a ship. The report indicated that the submarine, quote, was also DF'd many times late in May. Due to translation and miscommunication issues, this could mean traversing in snorkel depth and then diving on contact. The U.S. Navy did report that the submarine stopped on the Cape Verde Islands. The skipper later testified that they made the rest of the trip from Africa to Mar del Plata, alternating between surface and submerged sailing. Finally, U-977 arrived in Mar del Plata in mid-August, 108 days after departing from Norway. Inescapable fate. The German crew discussed that they should scuttle the submarine somewhere before approaching the coast, and then swim to shore clandestinely, but the feat would have entailed remarkable seamanship. The crew surrendered at 11 a.m. on August 17th. Lieutenant Hector Migone had spotted the incoming ship and alerted the authorities. The Germans were interned for a while and then became so-called prisoners of war, even though the war was already over. The men were extradited to the U.S., where they faced charges of having sunk the Brazilian cruiser Bahia. However, the astute commander had kept the full complement of torpedoes to avoid such accusations after the ceasefire. After the U.S., the crew was sent to the United Kingdom, where they faced accusations of carrying Nazi leaders to Argentina before surrendering. Schaefer contended that it was impossible to approach the coast before arriving at Mar del Plata. He said, quote, "Nobody had the opportunity to disembark secretly during the night. The distance was too great. Some crew members hovered with the idea of escaping if they arrived at night. How could we show that, apart from the crew members, certain wanted characters did not go ashore?" The crew was released in 1946, but the captain was retained, quote, "I was led before a group of high Anglo-American officers who made up an investigative commission specially sent to Argentina to clarify the mysterious case of U-977. Meanwhile, U-977 itself was seized by the U.S. Navy and sunk during a firing exercise in 1946. Theories. The fact that two submarines had managed to arrive in Argentina undetected by the Allies pointed to vulnerable weaknesses, and rumors started to spread immediately after the arrival of U-530. In July of 1945, Ladislav Szabo, an immigrant Hungarian journalist, published a theory in the newspaper Kritika speculating that Hitler could be in Argentina, and stories about a secret Nazi base beyond Patagonia in the South Pole also circulated. The arrival of a second submarine only ignited the fuel. In 1945, British newspaper Star published that, quote, "Doubts were always expressed about Hitler's fate, and many people are reluctant to believe the information about his death." Both American and British authorities extensively interrogated Schaefer, accusing him of hiding the Führer and bringing him to Argentina. Schaefer recalled that, quote, "As I could no longer tell them anything more than what I had already declared to the Argentines, they became impatient, as my submarine trip continued to elicit lively comments and big headlines." Schaefer was eventually released in 1947 and went back to Argentina, where he got married and wrote the book U-977, 66 Days Underwater. It was published in 1952 and was the first post-war memoir written by a U-boat officer. There was also speculation that the submarines were carrying precious stones, jewels, or even valuable art pieces that the Nazis had stolen from the best museums in Europe. The rumors eventually went away as authorities looked into the U-977 log and calculated the time and distance it traveled. To this day, there are those who still believe that the submarines did carry high-ranking Nazi officials, as many were tracked down to South America after the war. Thank you for watching our video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to our Dark Documentaries channels to get more exciting historical content. Also, let us know in the comments below whether you believe the official story, or if you think it's possible that Hitler escaped.